Hello students, welcome to maths class. So today we will start the homogeneous equations over. Now we will take non-homogeneous equations. So what I said, when non-homogeneous equations are given in differential equations, we have to follow three cases, right? So first we have to check the condition of first case. And if it is not satisfied, we have to go to the case condition for the case 2. If it is also not satisfied, then we have to take the case of a third one, right? So that is the procedure. Already we completed the first case and second case over. Now we will take the third case, okay? But directly we cannot go for third case or second case. First we have to check the first case. First case condition, one condition is there for the first case. What is that condition? B is equal to minus a dash. Next you take the second condition, a by a dash must be equal to b by b dash. So first condition is not satisfied, not case one. Second condition is not satisfied, not case two. Then we have to check the third case, okay? So now come to this question, little bit lengthy and 7 marks question, most repeated 7 marks question, okay? So solve the differential equation. What I said, whenever equation is dy by dx is equal to this form, it is called non-homogeneous equation. We have to reduce it into homogeneous equation by taking our cases. Okay, so come on, now take the solution. Given differential equation is, what is the given differential equation? It is dy by dx is equal to, so observe here, 3y is given, next minus 7x is given, plus 7 is given to you. Okay, so generally first x term, then y term, then constant term. So I will write first x term, minus 7x plus 3y plus 7 by 3x minus 7y minus 3. You consider this as your first equation. So come on, compare it with your ax plus by plus c by a dash x plus b dash y plus c dash. So a is equal to minus 7, b is equal to 3, c is equal to 7. Next, a dash is equal to 3, b dash is equal to minus 7, c dash is equal to minus 3. Now you check first condition. What is that? B must be equals to minus a dash. B is 3, a dash is 3, b is equal to a dash, but our condition is b must be equal to minus a dash. So your b not equal to minus a dash. Okay, first condition is not satisfied, so we cannot go for first case. Now case condition for the case 2, right? So what is that? A by a dash must be equal to b by b dash. A by a dash minus 7 by 3. B by b dash 3 by minus 7, not equal, right? So a by a dash not equal to b by b dash. Okay, so whenever b not equal to minus a dash and a by a dash not equal to b by b dash, we have to take we have to go for case 3. That's why here I mentioned the case 3. We have to take in x place x plus h, capital X plus h, and y place we have to take capital Y plus k. So you take dx is equal to capital dx and dy is equal to capital dy. Okay. So then what will be your equation 1, right? So then equation 1 will be, so what happens to your equation? We can write that as dy by dx is equal to minus 7 into x. What is your x? It is x plus h plus 3 into y plus k. Okay, plus 7 by downwards 3 into x plus h minus 7 into y plus k minus 3. Okay, so then we will have dy by dx is equal to minus 7x minus 7h plus 3y plus 3k plus 7 by, come on, we can take this as 3x plus 3h minus 7y minus 7k minus 3. Okay, so we can take this as dy by dx. This is the procedure to solve our case 3 problem, right? So whenever case 1 condition is not satisfied, case 2 condition is not satisfied, we have to take x is equal to x plus h, y is equal to y plus k, and dx, differentiation of this is dx and differentiation of y is dy. Now we have to substitute all these values in first equation. Then we got this equation. Come on, first try to write x term, right? Then try to write y term, 3y plus. So not plus here, minus is there, minus 7h, right? Minus 7h plus 3k plus 7, okay? By downwards also, first x term, 3x, right, minus 7y, okay, plus 3h, okay, minus 7k minus 3, okay. Now choose your h and k such that how you have to take equal, these two values must be equals to 0. 7h plus 3k plus 7 is equal to 0, and 3h minus 7k minus 3 is equal to 0. Okay, so we have to find h and k such that value is equal to 0, this value is equal to 0. How we will find? Like our point of intersection in a straight lines, first year we got our x and y values by applying the point of intersection. Same thing here we have to do. First k term we have to take, next constant term, next h term, next again k term. Similarly here, k term, constant term, h term, k term. Here you take h, k, 1, right? So h by, right? This is minus 9, minus 7, minus, minus 49, minus of minus, plus 49, by k into 7 threes are 21, minus, minus into minus, plus, 7 threes are 21, plus 1 by 7 sevens are, minus into minus, plus it is 49, minus 3 threes are 9. Okay, so we will have h by 40 is equal to k by 0 is equal to 1 by 40. So come on, h by 40 is equal to 1 by 40. So h is equal to 40 by 40 is equal to 1, right? Similarly, k by 0 is equal to 1 by 40. That means once I have taken these two, once I have taken these two to get our h and k values. So k is equal to 0 by 40, so k is equal to 0. We got h comma k values as 1 comma 0. Okay, so then what will be your equation? Suppose equation 1 over, now you take equation 2, right? Then 2 will be, what happens to your equation? It is dy by dx is equal to minus 7x plus 3y. that is that value we have taken as 0. Similarly downwards this value is taken as 0, right? So it is by 3x minus 7y. You consider this as third equation, okay, is third equation, and 3 is homogeneous equation of degree. What is the degree? 0. Why? If we take in x place kx, y place ky, so k can be common. Here also in x place we can take kx, in y place we can take ky, k common. So downwards k, upwards, right, k, k to the power of 1 minus 1, k to the power of 0. So it is a homogeneous equation of degree 0. Whenever it is homogeneous equation, we have to take, come on, put y is equal to vx. The problem is in terms of capital letters, no? That's why I have taken here also capital letters, y is equal to vx, okay? So now differentiating with respect to x on both sides. So dv by dy by dx is equal to, it is d by dx of, what is that, vx. It is a product form, okay? So whenever it is a product form, how we have to take? We have to keep first value as it is and we have to differentiate the second term, isn't it? And next we have to keep second term as it is and we have to differentiate first term. So what is your dy by dx? Dy by dx is equal to v plus x into dv by dx, okay? So then what will be your third equation? Then equation 3 will be, what happens to your third equation? Instead of dy by dx, we take v plus this one, right? X dv by dx, right, is equal to minus 7x plus 3 into y. What is y? Y is vx, right? So by next 3x, okay, so minus 7 into y is, it is vx, okay? So v plus x into dv by dx is equal to, x can be taken common, minus 7 plus 3v by, x is taken outside, 3 minus 7v, xx cancels, okay? So then you take x dv by dx is equal to sending v that side, minus 7 plus 3v by 3 minus 7v minus v. So taking the LCM, 3 minus 7v, and here minus 7 plus 3v minus v into 3, that is 3v, minus of minus plus 7v square. So plus 3v minus 3v cancels, okay? So now you are having x dv by dx is equal to, first let me write the positive term, 7v square minus 7 by 3 minus 7v, okay? So if you observe, these are the v terms, this is dv, send all the v terms to this side into dv, and dx is downwards, you send dx the other side, okay? So then what happens, integral, right, 3 minus 7v by 7v square minus 7 dv is equal to integral dx by x. Once the variables are separated, we will take integration. Directly I have taken y, means it is a little bit lengthy problem, okay? So first you bring all these values this side dv and send x dx that side. once variables are separated, all the v terms into dv, x terms into dx, then you take the integration. So in the integral upwards minus is there, we can take a separate integrals. So it is, come on, integral 3 by 7 v square minus 7 into dv minus integral 7 v by 7 v square minus 7 into dv is equal to log x. Okay, integral 1 by x dx is log x. Now from this you can take 3 by 7 outside, isn't it? From this 3, from this 7 can be taken outside, 1 by v square minus 1 dv. And here also from this 7, downward 7 can be taken outside, v by v square minus 1 dv is equal to, it is log x. Okay, so here 7, 7 cancels. Okay, so this is of the form integral 1 by x square minus a square form. We can write 1 as 1 square. So it is of the form integral 1 by x square minus a square, 1 by 2a into log of x minus a by x plus a form. So it is 3 by 7 into 1 by 2a log of v minus 1 by v plus 1. Okay, and for this, if you take t is equal to v square minus 1, then what is your dt by dv? It is 2v. So send that to this side, right? 1 by 2 dt is equal to v dv. So here we will write 1 by 2 outside, right? It is dt by t is equal to log x. Okay, so we can write this as 3 by 7 to the 14, right? Log of v minus 1. So log m by n, log m minus log n, right, is equal to log of v plus 1. Okay, minus 1 by 2 log t, right, is equal to log x. Plus all are in terms of log, so we will take the constant also in terms of log only, log c. Okay, so now we can take the LCM as 14, right, and we will send 14 that side. Okay, so it is 3 log of v minus 1 minus 3 log of v plus 1 minus, I have taken 14 as LCM, so here 2 is there, 2 7s are, so it is 7 log t. What is your t value? T is equal to v square minus 1, right, minus, okay, you take 14 log x plus 14 log c. So taking 14 as LCM and sending 14 the other side. Okay, so now again this v square minus 1 can be written as, 1 can be written as 1 square. A square minus b square is a plus b into a minus b form, right? So we can write that as 3 log of v minus 1, right, minus 3 log of v plus 1, okay, minus 7 log of, come on, a square minus b square form, v plus 1 into v minus 1, right? So, and if we take that one also, minus 14 log x is equal to 14 log c. Okay, so now again log m into log n can be written as log m plus log n. Log m into n can be written as log m plus log n. So we can write this as 3 log of v minus 1 minus 3 log of v plus 1 minus 7 log of v plus 1 minus 7 log of v minus 1, right? Minus 14 log x is equal to 14 log c. Okay, so now minus 3 log of v plus 1 minus 7 log of v plus 1, right? So this is minus 10 log of v plus 1, and 3 log v minus 1 minus 7 log v minus 1. These are minus 3 log of v plus 1 minus 7 log of v plus 1 minus 10 log of v plus 1. Next, v minus terms are these two, 3 minus 7, that is minus 4 log of v minus 1, right? Minus 14 log x is equal to 14 log c. So we can take minus 2 common and sending the other side, right? So instead of that, you take minus 2 common this side as well as minus 2 common that side, and cancel also, both are same. Okay, so it is 5 log of v plus 1, right, plus 2 log of v minus 1 plus 7 2s, right, 7 log x is equal to minus 7 log c. So dividing with minus 2 on both sides, or taking minus 2 common on both sides, both are same only, right? So it is, now we can write this as m log a, log a to the power of m, log of v plus 1, 5 plus log of v minus 1 to the power of 2, right? Next, plus log of x to the power of 7, log of c to the power of minus 7. Log m plus log n plus log p is log of m into n into p. So it is log of v plus 1 to the power of 5, v minus 1 to the power of 2, and x to the power of 7 is equal to log of c to the power of minus 7. Log log cancels, right? So now you are having v to the power of 1 whole to the power of 5, v minus 1 whole to the power of 2, x to the power of 7 is equal to c to the power of minus 7. It is some constant, right? Again, what is your v, right? Here we have taken y is equal to vx. So v is equal to y by x. Okay, whenever it is homogeneous, your v value is y by x. Already we solved so many problems, right? So it is nothing but y by x plus 1 to the power of 5, y by x minus 1 whole square, x to the power of 7. You consider this as some other constant, c to the power of minus 7. C is constant, so nothing but constant multiplying any number of times, you will get constant only, isn't it? So we can write 1 by c to the power of 7, that is nothing but some constant. Now take the LCM here, y plus x by x to the power of 5, right, y minus x by x to the power of 2, right, x to the power of 7 is equal to k. Write separately powers, it is y plus x to the power of 5 by x to the power of 5. Next, y minus x whole square by x square, x to the power of 7 is equal to k. So x to the power of 5, x to the power of 2, right? It is a product. In a product, if bases are same, powers should be added. So 5 plus 2, 7, right? So cancels, okay? So finally, we have to substitute y plus x values. So what is y? capital Y is equal to, you know that what is your capital Y? In the beginning we have taken X is equal to, yes, X is equal, small x is equal to X plus H. So what is capital X? X minus H. Small y is equal to capital Y plus K. What is capital Y? Small y minus K. Okay, so Y is equal to small y minus K plus small x minus H to the power of 5, right? Similarly, small y minus K minus small x minus H whole to the power of 2 is equal to K. So it is Y minus K is equal to, we got the K value as 0 and H value as 1, isn't it? So let me write here H is equal to 1, right? So H is equal to 1, K is equal to 0. Substitute plus X minus 1 whole to the power of 5. Here Y minus 0 minus X minus 1, right, whole square is equal to K, right? So it is Y plus X minus 1 to the power of 5, and here Y minus X minus of minus plus 1 whole square is equal to K is the solution of your question. Okay, so always this is little bit lengthy and case 3 problem, right? It belongs to 7 marks question. I think this is the most lengthy problem in your second year. Okay, so be careful. So the thing is, first we have to check the condition for the first case, condition for the second case. If both are not satisfied, then we have to take in small x place X plus H, small y place Y plus K. Then you take dx and dy values, substitute. You will get one equation first. In that, you equate this one and this one to be zeros, right? Like that we have to select, right? We have to choose. Then you will get H, K values. After choosing that H, K values, your equation will be like this, which is nothing but homogeneous equation. We reduced non-homogeneous into homogeneous equation. Whenever it is homogeneous equation, we have to substitute Y is equal to Vx. Differentiate it and substitute, right? Both sides X will get cancel. Okay, so after that you know it very well, if variables should be separated, after that we have to take the integration. Once the variables are separated, I have taken the integration. After that, by using the integration methods, we solve the problem. At the end, in place of capital Y, in place of capital X, again we have to substitute, right, your capital X value, capital Y value in the problem. That means our question is in terms of small x and small y. Answer also must be in terms of small x and small y. Okay, so little bit lengthy problem, so you should have lot of patience, lots of patience in solving this problem. Okay, so check your patience with this problem. Okay, you will get it, definitely you will get it, don't give up, right? You can get the answer at the end. Okay, so this is the third case in non-homogeneous differential equation problems. Case 3 problem is this one, right? Already we cleared the case 1 problem, we solved case 2 problem, this is the case 3 problem. Okay, so that's all for today. Have a nice day.